Hello learners, I am Dr. Subodh Kishirwani, working with Indira Gandhi National Open University. The topic which I am going to present today is Database Management System. I think this is part of our course called BCOS 183 BCom program, and we have seen that in our preceding lectures we have talked a lot about computers, we have talked a lot about application of computers, and in this preceding sessions, you know, in this second block, there is a chapter called Business Information System, and this database management system is part of this business information system, because when any business house, when any corporate house, or you know, any organization, you know, start making a database, start running a system, database is there going to play a very important role. And when you are going to talk about the database, you have to talk about how you are going to manage system, because in our preceding lectures, we have seen that data is a very, very intricate term in the present scenario. There was a time when data was just, you know, in your fingertips, but right now it's a real-time data. Today's data is no more useful for the tomorrow's purposes. So when you're going to talk about the data in the present scenario, you have to see how database is going to manage. And for the commerce student, or for the startups, or for the young generation, or for the first generation entrepreneurs who are going to establish, or for the small and medium sized enterprise, or it's a big enterprise, everywhere there is great use of data, and data can help the organization in their movements. What is the taste about the consumers, in which trend, you know, the market is going, what could be the scenario after 10 years or 20 years. This all talks about data. Data can be a living being, data can be a non-living being. So while going into this depth of this particular topic, we try to, you know, talk about the database management system, about the technology used in database management system, but on the other hand, we will see how it is going to be useful to our commerce graduates, or you know, the commerce students. Because when we talk about, you know, the computer application business, we see that how the computers, how the technologies, how the ingredients which are, you know, part of the computers can be useful, and data is one of the important ingredients, because these particular data converts into information, converts into knowledge, and these knowledge can decide the wisdom of the organization. So what we are going to do in this particular topic, that we will talk about you know, the database management, and there are certain systems which are used in managing the data. So if we go into the backdrop, you will find out that everything, anything have a front face and anything have a back face. So when you are running a software, because we have an exclusive session on software, and when you talk about the software, it talks about, you know, the front end and back end. Front end always, you know, give the presentation layer a website or an application which is at the front face. Say when we open any e-commerce portal, and when we start, you know, ordering any product, this could be the presentation layer, it could be the front face of the organization. But in the backdrop, you find out that there are certain database which is important, because when we talk about, you know, the e-commerce, we talk about, you know, the shopping, we talk about the orders, we talk about, you know, the database or the wallets. So these wallets are, you know, somewhat and certain cashbacks also. So when you do certain shoppings, when you have certain, you know, bought any product, and you get certain cashbacks, these cashbacks are, you know, stored in your database, in your wallets, in a cashback form, which you can use for the future purposes. This is nothing but, you know, the back office activity. So when you talk about front end testing, when you talk about, you know, the back end testing, this business layer and this database layer is very important. So front end is a front face, or if you talk about website, it could be PHP, it could be ASP.NET, or when you go into the backdrop, in a backdrop, you find out there are certain database which are, you know, exclusively working to execute this software. They are considered to be the back end, And these backends are somewhat, you know, called structured query language, which we usually call SQL and other things. So while going into the depth of this topic, we will definitely talk about other things. Now, what we have observed that when you talk about database management system, this database management system is a very total term. It's a very holistic term, which starts with software, it starts with management, have database, and then there are certain pedagogy of systems. There are certain data, there are certain softwares, and in between, you know, lots of technology is there, which is you know, running this database management system. So it's not like that database management is a one term or it's a single affair. It's a very accumulative affair. It's a very, you know, joint effort which talks about system management, software, database. So in this particular session, you know, we are going to throw a light on database management system from underneath to pinnacle, and we will see how this database management system is quite important, how it can give organization an edge or, you know, a niche to an organization by which they can compete with their business rivals and sometimes, you know, dominate the world market. There are some companies who have got multiple locations, who have got, you know, who are, you know, believes in cross-border business. So not having wear boots in one part of the world, but in other parts of the world. So how these companies are running, you know, because there are certain constraints, and this is where, you know, the database management is going to play a very important role. The taste about the consumers, the taste about the consumers differs from jurisdiction to jurisdictions. One jurisdiction is, you know, fond of one product and they are inclined towards that. But on the other hand, there are other consumers or, you know, the who are, you know, believes in different kind of product. So if we talk about, you know, some good brands, they always try to maintain these protocols and work accordingly. So this DBMS is somewhat, you know, is a combination of all those things. And when we go more into the depth of that, we will see how the things are going to be changed with the change of time and how this database management system is bringing a niche inside the organizations. So it's not like that it is somewhat, you know, taking care about the consumers. Somewhere we have observed that it is taking care about the employees, the counterparts, people who are, you know, working as a driving force in this particular organization. So it's helpful to them. So we will start with the database. A database is an organized collection of data, generally stored and accessed electronically from a computer system. And if you see here, the database are more complex. They are often developed using formal design and modeling techniques. If you go through this particular image, you will find out that that there is a huge storage at the bottom of any database, and there are certain, you know, the data which is coming from different sources. Some data is coming from through email, some are coming from websites. Now so if the app or, you know, the particular applications is dynamic in nature, the outside person, the consumers can, you know, put their data, and now these data are stored. Now the very good example is that if I do any shopping from e-commerce portal and I have bought the product, and I can share my experience in a text format. Now these experiences, these consumer experiences are you know, stored or saved in that particular portal, and these saved information can be used by the other consumers. For hotel industry, or, you know, for certain industries which is where, you know, the consumers are not in a position to feel the product, they can, you know, very much depend on the reviews given by the consumers. So these reviews are stored, and these reviews are somewhat, you know, shared by this particular softwares on this particular portal and you know, used by the others. So this is one of the way you see how the database is going to be done, and some statistical analysis is done, which is also, you know, storing here. Some, you know, the chip based technology based model is there. Some brick and mortar, you know, the information are there in the form of notes and other thing. And, you know, some tabulated information are there. So what, and there are certain information which are coming, you know, gradually with the change of time also. So what you observe that some outflow and inflow data are there. So if you see this particular image, you know, you come to the conclusion that data right now is not, you know, confined to like gathering of data or collecting of data is not confined to particular ways. There are n number of ways, there are ample ways by which data is coming and, you know, say storing in this particular database. So this is the real definition of database. And now how you're going to manage a data which is coming through, you know, the web portals, a data which is coming through messaging format, how you're going to store the data and how you're going to use the data. Now the question is that if somebody had, you know, flowed the information through any portal and now that portal is, you know, selling a now this portal is selling a product and the consumers have given a very adverse review of that particular product and majority of consumers had given. Now what the company is going to do, whether the company is going to revamp the product based on the, you know, suggestion given by the consumers, or they are going to do or they are going to apply certain steps by which the product can be fruitful to the consumers. So this is the way. Sometimes, you know, you are not in a position to judge the product, but you know the end users can reciprocate and then provide you a platform to revamp the product. So database is right now is not, you know, helpful for the future, you know, buying or selling or, you know, for, but sometimes, you know, very much useful to know the opinion about the consumers, because today's consumer is more a pull approach consumers, which always believes in, you know, the tailor-made or customized product. So here the role of the database, role of, you know, the storage is quite important. So anyway, what I was talking of, this is a chapter 5, and in this chapter 5 we have already covered, you know, the four chapters, the basic chapters, computers, application, other thing. And in this business information system, if you observe the preamble, you know, the chapters, the about the business information system, we have already talked about. We have massively talked about the data information with some real life scenarios and some very good examples which can distinguish that how the data differs from information. And then today discussion revolves around the database management system. So, and in the forthcoming session, we will definitely talk about decision support system, enterprise resource planning, then management information system, and then certain regulators which are there. So, what I mean to say that if you talk about, you know, the database management system, the DBMS in the present scenario talks about relational database management system. And we have seen in the preceding slide that relation is very important. The database is no more a database. It is basically a linkage of the data, how you're going to link the data. If the data is not going to link with the past records or the future records, it's no more useful. So how the relation between the data is going to work, this is a talk, this is, you know, a discussion about the database management system and data abstraction, database administrator and data retrieval, how you're going to retrieve the data. Because there are certain data which become obsolete, which, you know, evaporated. So how you're going to retrieve the data, like, you know, retaining the consumers who have left the product. They are we talk in marketing, we talk in management, that retention of the consumers. That if you are emphasized more on retaining the consumers, talking more about the brand loyalty, very easily you can, you know, get the market. So the good companies always believes in retrieval, how to retrieve the consumers so that the existing customers can not migrate to any other, you know, business rivals, and this is something which is there. So anyway, we will talk about this particular thing, that the basic function of database is to digitally store information. We have already talked that can be captured, retrieved and distributed easily at a later time. It's not like that whatever the data or whatever the information you have accomplished or captured, it can be used at that particular juncture or that particular time frame. There are certain data which can, you know, recapitulate and which can be used for the later time. So DBMS talks about all those aspects, the planning about the data and the use of the usage of the data. So database management system is a collection of program which enables its user to access data, manipulate data, reporting and representation of data. And what representation is very important, because sometimes what we observe that data usually is in a raw shape, and when you are going to represent the data, it takes the shape of our information, then knowledge, and then you know the this is going to helpful to the organization for working as a cash cow. So anyway, database management system are not a new concept, and as such had been first implemented in 1960. Charles Beckham integrated data store is said to be the first DBMS in history, with time database technologies involved a lot, while usage and expected functionalities of database have been with the intention that which had increased immensely. So what we observed that there was a time when database was and the data was quite, you know, rigid in nature and not much useful, but right now the integration is there and revamping is there. So this type of database management system is navigational database, relational database, SQL based DBMS, and then object oriented DBMS. If we talk about hierarchical, we have seen that that this type of DBMS employs the parent-child relationship of storing data, and structures like a tree which nodes represents, and configuration and settings are stored as tree structures, so with nodes. So the manner, you know, the tree used to work and collect the data in the same manner, this also works. So network DBMS, if we talk about this type of DBMS, supports many-to-many relationship. So it's not like that one data can be useful for one purpose. It can be used for other purpose. Like what we have seen that, you know, in e-commerce portal, that multiplicity is quite important right now. And these e-commerce portal are also somewhere what we observe that they are providing varieties of services. Like if we talk about, you know, one e-commerce portal which facilitates in recharging the mobile or the balances, but on the other hand provides a platform to do the shopping, and on the other hand one e-commerce portal is there which is, you know, provides a privilege to shop as well as, you know, watch the movies. So this is what, you know, the database linkage usage is there. And this server example is a database management system that implements the network model. So relational database management system, if we talk about this type of DBMS, defines database relationship in the form of tablets, also known as relations. And RDBMS, which we usually call relational database management system, does not support many-to-many relationship. So relational database usually have predefined data types, and it can be used by Oracle, Microsoft SQL, or, you know, the Amazon AWS is there. So this is there are certain different types of, and on the other hand we have object oriented relations database management system, and this type supports the storage of new data types and data to be stored in the form of objects. So now what we have and these objects are stored in the database have certain attributes like gender, age, and you know, the taste about the consumers, at what time, you know, one can do the shopping, one can do the window dressing, and whether these particular consumer can, you know, go for the food app or the travel app, or he's just confined to, you know, the single usage buying and selling. So this kind of model is coming up where we have observed that object oriented relational database management system is playing a very important role. And if you see this database system environment, you find out that procedures and standards are there, then you have certain programs, then you have end users, then database designers are there, then DBMS utilities are there, then hardware is one end, then system administrators are there. And what we have observed that if you see the standards, then database administrator, then DBMS, then data, then access, then application, then end user. So everything is linked with one another. It's not like that user information are quite static in nature, and only the, you know, in-house person who are, you know, maintaining the database can. It's quite dynamic in nature, where communication is two-way. So what we observe that today data is more more dynamic in nature and it's changing with the change of time. Maybe morning data is somewhat different, the evening data is somewhat different. So how there is a change in the data, how there is so much fast revamping in data is just because that it's real time in nature, it's more dynamic in nature, and with the change of time, with the change of span, the things are changing very, very fast. So anyway, there are certain examples of database, and Oracle is no doubt a pioneer in this. And Oracle has been making database products in 1979, and it is one of the well-recognized manufacturers worldwide. Then you have got Microsoft SQL Server, and MS is one of the most popular in the world. And they have a server 2008 servers, 2012 servers, and 2014. And then you know the MySQL is there. MySQL is an open source. I think I have already talked about you know the open source softwares in my preceding slide, that these open source softwares are you know available with the source codes, a programming language. In the background, we find out that any software is equipped with the programming language, and these programming languages are in machine language. So, and when you get this programming language, and when you execute this, when you run this, you get the program run in this particular format. So, it had a combination of you know the front end activity or the back end activity. There are certain you know database or the back-end activities which are in open source and the front-end also. So PHP could be the front-end or .NET could be the front-end, and back-end, in the back-end the MySQL is there, which is quite powerful. So this MySQL has gained transaction, and DBMS, and it's for a web-based business also, like you know the example which I have quoted about e-commerce or m-commerce, because whole scenario is changing and web application is going to play a very important role. And this Android application, this Google Play Store, and you know the applications which are you know work through app is very important. Then Microsoft Access is there, and this is also a database application which is quickly finding and used for e-commerce sites. So and content management system, CMS is very important in the present scenario, because the way things are changing, I think it's not like that only the commerce industry or the trade and business is just applying you know the this database as a thing. There are certain e-learning organizations, like the upcoming institutions which are in brick and mortar mode. If you talk about you know the MIT, which is number one institutions in the world, so they are also you know come up with their open platform called MIT Courseware. So while keeping the content, they are making the database about the learners, they are making the database about the institutions, they are making a database about the contents. And when you are going to keep the content, it's not like that you have put the content in the static mode. The CMS or the learning management system is a two-way affair. It's provide you know the teacher instructor and you know the learners or the students to come under one platform. And this is the opportunity where you know they can you know dynamically interact with one another. So it's what we observe that this access comes standard, and these you know the tools are no doubt playing a very important role. SAP is no doubt a big player, and when we have a session on enterprise resource planning, which is part of this particular chapter, SAP is AG is a German company, and SAP stands for System Application and Product. It's a German vendor, and they are into ERP softwares, and they make a software for Fortune 500 companies, a software which have a huge cost and which require you know a lot of customization. So, and it's for the organization which have a base of you know billions of consumers and you know millions of employees. So they have developed a package which could be in a cloud mode, which could be in a brick and mortar mode, and these database are no doubt is definitely going to add a feather in a cap. And these adaptive server enterprise is designed to handle high performance transaction based application such as those used in banking and finance. And for banking also, there are certain indigenous packages. Infosys is a company which have developed a package known as Finacle, which is massively used by the banking industry. And you see how the banks had changed themselves, the core banking phenomena had come up, the net banking had come up, the wallets have replaced the conventional currency, and some countries are you know exclusively depend on the virtual currencies, and maybe it could be the legal tender in the coming years. So these are the changes where data is going to play a very important role, because these databases are working as a blockchain technology, and when these blockchain technologies are there, it's no doubt quite important. So looking for a solid database management system starting point is that Amazon is also doing a great job in this direction. They have a entity called AWS, Amazon Web Services, and these web services are somewhat, you know, working in this database management system and integration with the help of cloud, because cloud computing is something which is a change of an hour, which is a need of an hour. And if you know, in the coming years you find out the majority of servers are moving from brick and mortar mode to click and mortar mode, and there this real time information is very easily, you know, update in cloud servers, because if you have a brick and mortar servers, the lead time is very high. To reduce this lead time, to get an edge, to get a niche, I think there this model is going to play a very important role. So what we observe that as I was talking, that database management system is not a front end activity or the activity which is exclusively designed for the consumers. As I have talked about, there are certain big organizations who have got a gigantic base of the employees. To manage these employees, I think they have started using, you know, the employee database management system, which we usually call, you know, the HR modules, or we usually call the payroll module or performance appraisal module. So these modules are, you know, are exclusively designed or customized or tailor-made for the particular employees, and it can equip with many things like performance analyst, work report, task status, system backup, employees detail and designations, and how to manage employees, employee leave requests. So there are certain issues which are, you know, related with employees are taken care by that. So right now what happened, the database of the consumers is very important, but on the other hand, database of employees is also coming up in a big way. And there are some good organizations which were no more there in the past, but what we observed that in the coming years, you know, within decade or two, they have created a benchmark and right now number one. Google example is a very good example, because we have seen that Google always stands in the phenomena called good place to work, and this company have always taken care about the employees and how they interact with the employees, how they tackle the employees, how they are serious about the employees. That is more important, because the manner they take care about the employees, that no doubt they always believe in work in workship, but on the other hand, they give a lot of privilege to the employee that about their leaves, about, you know, the flexibility in working hours and the accomplishment of task. And so this is where, you know, this database management system is playing a very important role, and it can also link with their performance also. If you are providing them a flexibility, like we have seen that in pandemic stage we are going on, and work from home culture had come up, and this work from home culture was initiated initially by the social networking tycoons like Facebook or Google. So they were the one who have introduced this phenomena, and now they are very much adhered to that. So they have communicated to the employees that if they are feeling comfortable with work from home model, they can do that. But the database is, you know, somewhat linked with the cloud, and very easily the performance of the employee, their you know, the efforts or their dedication towards the organization is also going to be monitored with this software. So database is you know, not just confined to just, you know, the simple data, but, you know, here doing one step ahead to that. So anyway, what we have observed that analytics and algorithm is very important when you talk about the data, when you talk about, you know, the database analysis. And we have seen that analytical database is there, and raw data are tables, and then derivative tables are there if you see this particular image. And database are very easily, you know, moving from raw to derivative tables, and then analytical tools are there where certain algorithm is going to be used. And either it could be, you know, the organization called Facebook or Google, we have seen that how they are intermingled with each other in a very, very faster mode. So this is the new way of new approach. This is the new, definitely a new way by which, you know, the analysis is going on, and search engine optimization, or we talk about, you know, the analysis, or we talk about the analytics, or we talk about, you know, certain storing of data, that is more important. There are certain data which become redundant with the change of time. So how you're going to eliminate those data, how you're going to clean those data, because if you're going to keep the data which are redundant in nature and have no usefulness, ultimately what will happen that it's going to store, and this cloud computing and this, you know, virtual way of interaction, virtual way of storing the things is a one step in this direction. And companies are changing and creating an edge with the help of that. Because if you are storing a real-time data in a very faster mode, you know the taste about the consumers, you know, and accordingly you can do that. And you know the trend about the things. There were certain industries, there were certain, you know, organizations which were doing very well in this pandemic stage and have, you know, established a huge profit. But on the other hand, that because, you know, with the help of technology, but on the other hand, there were certain, you know, industries which have not changed themselves and not equipped with the technology, so they were out from the pictures. So this is how, you know, the trend is going to be changed, and database analytics purely talks about the trend, the pedagogy, or, you know, the methodology which we are using. So database, there are certain vendors which are there. Oracle is no doubt one of the vendors. IBM database 2 is there, then their relational tends to be larger, and then non-relational database are there. So right now the trend is going to be changed, and you find out in the coming years more players are coming up, and more, you know, approach is going to be come up. So what we have observed that if you talk about real life scenarios of database used by business houses, Facebook uses MySQL as a primary database management system for all the structures, and they have got the huge servers where they are talking the data in terabytes, and the billions of terabyte data are used, and these data are, you know, in a very different format. It's in video format, it's in text format. Now storing is a very big challenge, and for that they have got certain conversions with them, and these conversions are trying to store the data in a very less space format. So Facebook, if we talk about, uses MySQL as a primary database management system for all structured data storage, such as different wall posts, information of various users, their timeline, so on. On the other hand, we have seen that e-commerce is not this e-commerce portal Amazon is known for its database or the cloud computing, and this company have created an edge is because of the, you know, the database management system, and the way, you know, the human intervention is reducing day by day, the robots are coming up, and how robots are, you know, extracting the data from the database in a very, very short span. So this two largest database combined, and this for what we observe that Amazon publishes a total number of database they maintain and volume of data each database contain. The amount of data we know Amazon houses would increase substantially. So what does it mean? It means that, you know, this that these companies are the assets of these companies are there, you know, the management of the data, and the huge number of data which is coming every day, and so there is a huge number of inflows and there is huge number of outflow, and there must be certain synchronization between inflow and outflow. So how you are going to redundant the data which are static in nature, and there are certain consumers are you know, quite, you know, frequent in buying the things, but from, you know, from last 6 months they are not using it. So these consumers can be in the different list, and those who are frequent consumers, they could be in different list. So on the basis of the utility, on the basis of, you know, their buying trends, on the basis of their, you know, buying habits, the privileges need to be given. We have observed that if we are using the portal in a very frequent manner, we become a privileged customers, and the privileged consumers or the privileged customers are getting more benefit as comparison to the usual customers. So the privileged customers are provided the extra benefit, I think their morale could be go up, and by that way they can have more, you know, loyalty towards the brand or towards the company. So this is where database management is very important. And if you see this is very important thing, because we talk about the data, we talk about the, you know, the information, and we have seen that, you know, the data mining and data warehousing is a new phenomena. It's a phenomena which was there a decade back, but right now the model had been changed, the pedagogy had been changed, and artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning, blockchain technology, Internet of Things, we observed that these are, you know, somewhat, you know, adding a flavor to this. Data warehouse and data mining have a very, very minute difference. If you talk about data warehouse is something which is, you know, more like artificially created or, you know, stored for the particular purpose, and data mining is something where things are automatically come in a natural mode comes. So what we observe that when you use the artificial intelligence, the machine learning, automatically the data, with the help of this data mining, there is no use of human intervention, and machine is extracting the information, and these information are stored in the data warehouse for future purpose. When any company, you know, manufacture any inventory, I think they used to keep the data, they used to keep the product in the warehouse, and these warehouse are right now very strategically located so that you have a less storage of inventory and you can very easily, you know, capture the huge number of jurisdictions. So that is where, you know, the model is going to be done. If you have a data plan in a such a manner, you can do the data mining and you can do the data warehouse, and very easily what you can do, you can extract the data as per your requirement. Sometimes what happens, some data is quite useful to us at particular time frame, but after certain time it's no more useful to us. And but if we evaporate those data, if we, you know, eliminate those data, what will happen? We are not in a position to recall the data after certain time, after certain juncture. So this data warehouse is going to play a very important role where the redundant data, where, you know, the data which is not going to be quite stagnant in nature is kept at one place. So that is the reason we observe that that all these big companies who are playing with the data are using this phenomena. We have got a very good example of Google. I think there was a time when we opened 3-4 accounts in Gmail or in particular email, which was, you know, long back was there, like Rediff or Hotmail are there. After certain time, we get a mail from the company that, or to the email providers, that that you have not used this particular facility for either 6 months or a year. If you are not going to use it, we are going to shut down this email ID. So this is where, you know, the way by which they are knowing about the stagnant users and try to, you know, narrow down it, try to give them a alarming bell so that if they want to continue, they can continue, and otherwise they can discontinue by closing the account. So if they discontinue, certain storage will come up which can be used for that. So change is now a very important thing, and the companies are also very smart into it. Like if we talk about the email providers, we have seen that how the Google is, you know, having a different format of delivering the services as far as the email is concerned. For the initial customers, they are giving 15 GB, which is almost free, and anybody can open an account and use this 15 GB. And moment you cross this 15 GB, you have to pay, you know, then they have a plan for 100 GB, then terabyte and other thing is there. For 100 GB, they ask certain amount. So what does it mean? That if you need a storage, because they have created a habit of, you know, putting the data on drive, Google Drive, which we usually call the cloud computing, and then they can, you know, provide you a way to you keep the data in the cloud. Because if you have put the data on the cloud, you don't require, you know, much space in the hard disk, and very easily, you know, you can use it from different devices, and if you give access to somebody else, they can also use it. So this is the beauty of cloud computing, and this is where the data analysis is going to play a very important role. And these companies are having a zero tolerance approach where they keep the data on their servers, and they store the data because the data are sensitive in nature and, you know, owned by the lakhs of consumers or the billions of consumers. So it's a moral duty of these email providers to, you know, keep the storage of these data, and because data privacy is also very important. So all those, you know, the approach, all those, you know, the tools or the framework they have developed, and they are doing accordingly. So anyway, we have seen that there is a way, there is a model, there is a pedagogy by which data where is going to be used. Operational database, we have seen that at the left side it starts from there. Then you have ERP. We are having a full-fledged session on enterprise resource planning, which is one of the important component of this particular course and a particular chapter. So this enterprise resource planning definitely talks about how things need to be integrated and how the integration is going to play a very important role when you talk about, you know, the resource of the of any organization. So external sources is there, then extract, clean and transform, load, refresh, then output, data warehouse is there, then how this data warehouse is there, then OLAP is there, online application protocol servers are there, and output, query, report, analysis, and data mining. Data mining we have already talked about. So this bottom tier, middle tier, and top tier is there, where data moves, starts from in a raw manner and moves in a data mining approach. So this is a business intelligence. And if you see the data warehouse, then you have BI delivery platform, you have CRM, ERP, point of sale, then finance is there. Because when we talk in a business perspective, we have to see how the technology is going to helpful to the business. And by and large, you know, how the technology is going to helpful and, you know, facilitate the business, that is more important. So reporting, then this finance is how the finance is going to take in care, because buying a technology is not everybody cup of tea. More talking about the technology, more investment in the current trends. And if you are not in a position to invest more in technology, ultimately what will happen, you will be out from the picture in a very gradual manner. So there are small fishes, there are big fishes, and right now what happened, big fish are going to, you know, mug up the small fishes. So technology is the way by which you can retain yourself, you can establish yourself into the market. And when you talk about the technology, when you talk about the computers, you talk about the database, you talk about, you know, the different contemporary thoughts which are going on a day-to-day basis. So which helps executive managers and other corporate users to make informed business decisions. So this BI is a technological driven process for analyzing and presenting actionable information. So now we have seen that the trend had been changed. The deep learning, machine learning had been come up, and which is now bifurcating the things into access data, analyze data, develop and deploying. So access data are, you know, certain things, then analyze are pre-proposing, then developing AI models, algorithm development and search engine optimization, because artificial intelligence is a new thought. And with this artificial intelligence, what is happening that there's a great use of robots and collaborative use of robots. So that is the reason we talk about that there's no term called robots, but it's a cobot, that is collaborative effort of robots and humans. So it's an intermingling approach between technology and humans, and how the algorithm is going to use. And when you talk about the algorithm, you're talking about the mathematics or statistics. And when you talk about the mathematics in business, I think mathematics can give you the trend that when the business is going to be shut down, what could be the shelf life of the business, when customer is going to exhaust with this particular product, and when you are going to come up with a new product so that you sell, you are going to retain into the market. What we observe that, and this modeling and simulation is very important, because there are certain simulators which are, you know, creating a replica of the existing product and knowing about the taste and the approach about the consumers. Then enterprise system and embedded device are there. These embedded devices are chip based and interlinking are there. So these devices are linked with one another, and hardware is quite, you know, acquainted with the software. Software is quite acquainted with the hardware. So devices are now becoming more faster. There was a time when we have a hard disk drive, and now we have solid state drive. So hard disk drive, if you talk about, it's media based and, you know, just having a storage. And when you talk about solid state drive or M2, you see, you know, that certain technologies are inbuilt into it, and you will find out that these technologies are somewhat, you know, work as a processors also. So now the memory is equipped with the speed, and if you believe in solid state drive, it is more, you know, equipped with the contemporary approach and having the flavor of, you know, not storing the thing, but, you know, moving the device more faster. So this embedded device are coming up, and there are certain, you know, the database which are there, which are helping the e-commerce, and these applications are somewhat, you know, changing the way the commerce is going to be changed. So trade and commerce are changing with the change of applications, and what we observe that with the change of time, you find out that there is a great use of database, and this and the companies are massively depend on this e-commerce. I think this database management system is a backbone of any company, because data is as important as the product, and if the companies are giving more time on twisting the data or using the data in a positive manner, I think they can do the wonders, and they can definitely create an edge as compared to the business rivals. So I think I am winding up by this. In our coming sessions, we will definitely consider more topic which can talk about the linkage between the computers and its application in business. Thank you very much. Thank you.